Hello everyone, I am Kunkati Preeti. Welcome to the brief presentation on error characterization of L-band passomicroradiometry in soil moisture and VOD retrievals. Soil moisture and vegetation are two critical drivers in land-atmospheric interactions. Their dynamics can be estimated with the help of L-band passomicroradiometry by analyzing the interactions of microemissions using radiative transfer models. These microemissions are influenced by the soil properties and the vegetation conditions. The vegetation in an RTM is characterized by vegetation optical depth and scattering albedo. The zeroth order or tau omega model is most commonly used RTM in baseline retrieval algorithms. This model assumes vegetation to be a smooth layer and weakly scattering mediums, which limits its application to the dense vegetated regions where multiple scattering effect is predominant. To overcome this, the single scattering albedo in zeroth order model is been replaced with effective scattering albedo to accommodate for multiple scattering by Kurum et al. In 2013. Recently, higher order models are being developed to accommodate for multiple scattering, namely Feldman's first order model and 2S emission model, which are adapted to retrieve soil moisture and VOD in dense vegetated pixels. However, the relative contributions of these RTMs and their model parameterizations in studying the error in soil moisture and VOD retrievals are left unexplored. Hence, the goal of present study is to characterize the error and uncertainty contributions from RTMs and their model parameterizations in L-band soil moisture and VOD retrievals. The RTMs considered in the present study are zeroth order model, 2S emission model, and Feldman's first order model. The model parameterizations used are surface roughness and single scattering albedo. H and omega parameters are propagated within a specified range from previous literature for each RTM to generate the ensembles of SM and VOD retrievals at each test site using multi-temporal inversion algorithms. After the generation of ensembles, a multi-factor ANOVA approach is adopted to decompose the error and uncertainty contributions from RTMs, model parameterizations, and their interactions in SM and VOD retrievals. A time series of SM retrievals, in situ SM data, and SMAP and SMOS SM products along with precipitation is as shown in this figure. The SM retrievals are validated with respect to the in situ SM data. The peaks in the retrievals corresponds to the precipitation events. The realizations due to the propagation of H and omega induce large bias in the retrievals. In case of dense vegetation pixels, there is some sensitivity due to the change in omega parameter in SM retrievals. The 2S emission model retrievals are slightly better than the other two models in most of the land cover types. The VOD retrievals are compared with SMAP SCAV, SMAP MDCA, SMOS IC, and also the VOD retrievals are compared with vegetation indices, namely NDVI and EVI. The inverted bars represent the precipitation events. We can see a peak in the retrieval after a corresponding precipitation event. The VOD retrievals are in good agreement with SMAP VOD products and SMOS IC VOD products for most of the land use land cover types. The correlation between the vegetation indices and retrievals is very low except for some grasslands and croplands. This is due to the correspondence of L-band VOD with stem water content rather than the leaf water content. The error in SM and VOD retrievals are decomposed into the contributions of H, omega, RTM, H and their interactions as shown in this figure for all test sets. From this figure, we can infer that omega is a predominant source of error in both SM and VOD retrievals for most of the land use land cover types. From this figure, we can infer that at dense vegetated pixels, there is uncertainty in the VOD retrievals due to the H parameter, which is more than from other land use land cover types. From this figure, we can also infer that VOD retrievals are slightly more sensitive to the model parameters than the SM. The uncertainty contributions from H, omega, RTM and their interactions in the SM and VOD retrievals are being decomposed in all test sets as shown in this figure. From this figure, we can infer that the SM performs similar in all land use land cover types with more uncertainty due to the interactions of model parameters rather than their individual contributions to the SM uncertainty. Whereas in VOD, the VOD retrievals are in greater risk with the scattering effect and RTM parameterizations even after removal of the bias in the retrievals, which is depicted from these figures. From error decomposition analysis, it can be inferred that large portion of uncertainty is from the scattering albedo followed by the RTM, and the error from scattering albedo increases under dense vegetated conditions. The effect of H is greater in BOD retrievers, and this is very high in dense vegetated regions. From the uncertainty decomposition analysis, it can be inferred that in soil moisture retrievals, the major source of uncertainty is from the interactions of model parameters, and in retrieval of VOD, the uncertainty is predominantly from omega and its representation by the RTM. The uncertainty due to RTM is very low in soil moisture retrieval due to the similar retrievals in all three RTMs. This study can be adopted to characterize the uncertainty from model parameters and RTMs in different frequencies, which could be useful for developing collaborative retrieval algorithms for upcoming CAMR mission. These are some of the references used in the present study. Thank you for your attention.